thing's traveling at 4,000 miles an hour.
You won't want to look, but you can't help it. You won't believe your eyes, but you'll never forget what they see.
Missile technology has been overhyped for a long time. And you'd think that in the 30-odd years since the end of the Cold War, we'd have moved on from such hyperbolic claims. Enter the hypersonic missile. So, hypersonic weapons. Are they a game-changing new technology? Do they make the United States safer? Do they live up to their hype? To answer these questions, we talked to Dr. Cameron Tracy.
So, there are a lot of popular myths going around about hypersonic weapons, but our analysis shows that there's a lot more hype than new technology when it comes to these expensive weapons. Here's the reality. There is a difference between ballistic and hypersonic missile trajectories that impacts their visibility to early warning systems. But this isn't great news for hypersonics, and it certainly doesn't make them harder to spot. When ballistic missiles, the current technology for fast warhead delivery, leave the atmosphere, the rockets on which they're launched fall back to Earth, while the warhead continues to fly high into outer space before falling to its target. After launch, hypersonic missiles quickly re-enter the atmosphere and glide to their target. And as they glide, they're maneuverable at relatively low altitudes. That could make them harder to detect by radar systems on the ground. Except nations like the United States do not rely solely, or even primarily, on ground-based radar for detecting an incoming missile. They also use satellites that watch for the light given off by hot objects. Because hypersonic gliders fly through the atmosphere, they stay much hotter than ballistic missiles, which makes them easier to detect. Our analysis showed that when flying over intercontinental ranges, the distance between the US and Russia or China, for example, hypersonics actually fly slower than ballistic missiles. And it's because of that new gliding feature we just talked about. When hypersonic missiles enter their glide phase, atmospheric drag slows them down and makes them, again, more vulnerable to detection. Unlike ballistic missiles, which fly mainly through the vacuum of outer space, where there is no drag. So these claims that the advent of hypersonic weaponry will shorten warhead delivery times are just false. Absolutely not. And this is probably the most dangerous myth of all. Right now, Russia, China, and the US are engaged in a hypersonic arms race. And some of the propaganda is alarming.
Putin showed a video as proof simulating Russian missiles apparently raining down on Florida.
This manufactured tension, for no strategic advantage, only increases the likelihood of conflict and misdirects resources from other important national needs. Bottom line, hypersonic weapons aren't faster, aren't harder to detect, and aren't actually making us safer. They're a bad investment for the security of our country.